Morning children, in yesterday's class we discussed the first problem of exercise 10.2. Today we will discuss second problem onwards. So let us see the second problem. The volume of a cylinder is 308 cm³. Its height is 8 cm. Find its lateral surface area and the total surface area. So, what is given there? Volume of a cylinder is 308 cm³. Its height is 8 cm. Height of a cylinder h equal to 8 cm. What we want to find? Lateral surface area and total surface area. So before that, what we know? We should know the radius of the cylinder. So what is given here? Value of the cylinder is given. So what is the value of the cylinder formula? We know that according to the given problem, value is 308 cm³. According to our formula, the value of a cylinder is pi r square h. Therefore, pi r square h is given that it is equal to 308. So here h is also given. We can find the r value, r square value. That is r square equal to 308. Send pi and h right side, then it becomes division 308 by pi into h. We can substitute there r square equal to 308 by, what is value of pi? Right, very good, 22 by 7. By 7 becomes s into 7 into, what is h? H equal to 8. Now r square equal to 308 into 7 by 22 into 8. Any cancellation is there? Right. 11 twos 22. 11 twos 22. Remaining 8. 88. 11 eights 88. Cancel. Next two. 4 twos 8. 4 sevens 28. That is r square equal to 7 into 7 by 2 into 2. R equal to, what we can write that? 7 into 7, 7 square, 49 by 4. That is square root of 7 into 7 by 2 into 2. That equal to 7 by 2. This is the radius of the required cylinder. And what is asking? Lateral surface area and total surface area. Lateral surface area of a cylinder equal to, what is the lateral surface area of cylinder? Lateral surface area of cylinder equal to 2 pi r h. Substitute that. Equal to 2 into 22 by 7 into, what is r? R equal to 7 by 2 into, what is h? H equal to 8. Cancellation 7 7 2 2 22 into 8. How much it is? 176. 176 centimeter square. It is the lateral surface area of the cylinder. Next, what is given? Total surface area of the cylinder. He is asking. Total surface area of the cylinder, that is total surface area of cylinder equal to, we discussed, what is the formula? Right, very good. 2 pi r into h plus r, that is 2 into 22 by 7 into, what is r? R equal to 7 by 2 into h plus r. What is h? H equal to 8 plus R 7 by 2. Any cancellation? 7, 7, 2, 2, that is 22 of, how much it is LCM is 2, 2, 8, 6, 60, 60 plus 7. Now, again, 2 ones, 2 elevens, equal to 11 into 16 plus 7, 23. Now, 23 into 11, how much it is 23 into 11? Equal to 253 centimeter square. 253 centimeter square. It is the total surface area of a given cylinder. Next, come to the problem 3. Third problem. See the third problem. A metal cuboid of dimension 22 cm into 15 cm into 7.5 cm was melted and cast into a cylinder of height 14 cm. Then what is its radius? So it is given the metal is in the shape of cuboid. So cuboid means it has a length, breadth and height. So here we have to observe that when the cuboid is melted and formed in the shape of a cylinder, then what is going on to change? Just shape is going to change, but the volume remains same. We should remember that when the object is melted and reforms into the another shape, then there is no change in the volume. So that we should remember. So according to that, what is given? Length of cuboid L equal to 22 centimeters, breadth of cuboid B equal to 15 centimeters, height of cuboid H equal to 7.5 centimeters. Then value of cuboid B equal to LBH. What is L? 22 into 15 into 7.5. It is melted and cast into a cylinder of height 14 centimeters. So when it is melted, what we know, volume of the cuboid and the volume of the sphere should be equal. Therefore, volume of cuboid is equal to volume of a cylinder, because if it is melted and reforms into another shape, there is no change in the volume. Therefore, volume of the cylinder equal to volume of the cuboid. Therefore, volume of cylinder. What is the value of cylinder formula? According to our formula, volume of cylinder is right. Pi r square h equal to 22 into 15 into 7.5. Height of the cylinder is also given. Height of cylinder h equal to, how much it is given? Height of a cylinder equal to 14 centimeters. Height of a cylinder equal to 14 centimeters. Now substitute this, that is pi R square H equal to 22 into 15 into 7.5. That is R square equal to 22 into 15 into 7.5 pi H becomes as a division pi into H. R square equal to 22 into 15 into 7.5 by, you know what is the value of pi? Right, 22 by 7, pi 7 becomes as into 7 into H. What is height? Height equal to 14 centimeters. Now simplification, 22 get cancelled. Next 7 months, 7 twos, 14, 2 ones, 2 sevens, 14.25 is 10. That is R square equal to 7.5 into 7.5. Then R equal to square root of 7.5 into 7.5. 7.5 into 7.5, that equal to 7.5. It is the radius of cylinder. Next come to the fourth problem. Let us see fourth one. An overhead water tanker is in the shape of a cylinder, has a capacity of 616 cubic meters. The diameter of a tank is 5.6 meters. Find the height of a tank. Here it is given that overhead tank is in the shape of cylinder. Its capacity is capacity of 616 cubic meters. In some books it is given that liters. If it is in liters, we have to change into the cubic meters. After converting into meters, then only we have to solve. But in some books it is given that 616 cubic meters. Some other books it is given that 616 liters. If it is in liters, means we should convert into the cubic meters. Then we have to solve. Now I am considering this is the 616 cubic meters. That is value of a cylinder. Value of a, what is it, overhead tank, value of a tank equal to 616 meter cube. So actually what is the volume of a tank is in the shape of a cylinder, that is why value of the cylinder is right pi r square h equal to 616 meter cube. Diameter of a tank is, diameter of a tank D equal to 5.6 meters. We required radius, not a diameter. So radius of a tank R equal to half of the diameter, that is 5.6 by 2, that equal to 2.8, 2 ones, 2 twos, plus 2 x, 2.8 meters. Now, substitute in this, what is that pi r square h is equal to 616 and radius r equal to 2.8, what do I find? Find the height of a tank, that is h you have to find. By substituting r value in this, that is, by taking this equation, pi r square h equal to 616. H equal to 616 by pi r square. That equals substitute that 616 by pi means 22 by 7. That becomes something to 7. R square, what is r? R equal to 2.8 into 2.8. It is the r square. So is there any cancellation? 7 ones, 7, 0.4, 2.8. 11 twos, 22. 11 fives, 55. remaining 6 and 6, 66. 11, 6, 66. Again next 2 ones, 2, 2 is 4, 2 8, 16, 28. So it is 2.8, it is 28. 2.8 ones, and we can cancel. 2.8 means what is there? Point is there, it is 28. So if we remove the point, it will become 0. Or directly we can cancel that 2.8 ones, 2.8 tens, 28. And next, here 0.4 is there. That equal to how much it is? Equal to 10 by 0.4. How can we remove the decimal in the denominator? So after decimal, how many digits are there? Only one digit. So by putting the 0 on numerator, we can remove the denominator decimal by 4. That equal to 100 by 4 means that is 25. It is the, what is this? Height of a tank equal to 25 meters. That is the required answer. Next come to the fourth completed, fifth problem. Fifth one. Let us see what is the fifth problem. A metal pipe is 77 centimeters long. The inner diameter of a cross section is 4 centimeters. The outer diameter being 4.4 centimeters, given in the figure, see that ones. Then find its inner curved surface area, outer curved surface area, and total surface area. So the metal pipe is in the shape of cylinder, first of all. What is given the figure? You can observe the figure. Figure is given, that is height of the pipe is in the shape of cylinder. It is the pipe. The inner diameter is R and the outer diameter is M of denoted here capital R, and height is given 77 centimeters. It is given 77 centimeters. We have to find the inner curved surface area and outer curved surface area, and next you total surface area. Height of a pipe H equal to, how much it is given? 77 centimeters. The inner diameter of a cross section is 4 centimeters. Inner diameter D equal to 4 centimeters, we required radius. Therefore, inner radius R equal to half of the diameter, that is half of the 4 is 2 centimeters. That is the inner radius. Next, we have to find the inner curved surface area. Inner curved surface area of a pipe. Pipe is in the shape of cylinder. Therefore, curved surface area of the cylinder equal to, we know what is the formula? Right. 2 pi r h. Substitute it. 2 into 22 by 7 into what is r? R equal to 2. And what is h height? That is 77 centimeters. Cancellation. 7 ones, 7 ones, 7, 7 elevens. So what is remaining? 2 into 22 into 2 into 11. 11 to 22, 22 into 22, next 20 into 2. That is equal to 44 into 11 to 22. How much it is 44 into 22? It becomes as 968 centimeter square. It is the inner curved surface area of a pipe. Inner curved surface area of pipe. Next, what is asking? Outer curved surface area. Outer curved surface area, that is, I am doing here, second one in that, outer curved surface area of a pipe. Pipe is nothing but it is the form of cylinder. Therefore, what is the formula? Right, very good. 2 pi rh. Outer radius is I am denoting by capital R. That's why I am writing capital RH. So, what is the outer radius? Outer diameter of a pipe. Capital D equal to, how much it is given? 4.4 centimeters. 4.4 centimeters. Then the outer radius of a pipe, capital R, equal to half of the diameter, that is again 4.4 by 2, that is 2.2 centimeters. It is the outer radius of a pipe. Now, outer curved surface area of pipe equal to outer curved surface area of a pipe equal to 2 pi rh, that equal to 2 into 22 by 7 into, what is r? 2.2 into, what is height? Height is already below that, 77. Again, 7 ones, 7 elevens cancel. 22 into 2, 44, 44 into 2.2 into 11, multiply 44 into 11. 44 into 11 into 2.2. Multiply what we get. The product is 44 into 11. 48. Again. 5324 into 2.2. That is, the product is 1064.8 centimeter square. It is the outer curved surface area of the pipe. Next, what is asking? Total surface area. Thank you. you have to observe that total surface area means inner curved surface area, outer curved surface area, and the area of the ring. We have to find, we have to add these three, then we will get the total surface area. Total surface area of a pipe equal to outer curved surface area plus inner curved surface area plus area of ring. That is, it is ring is there, no? Area of this ring we have to find. So before that, first of all, we will find the area of the ring. Area of a ring equal to, already we know what is that, pi into r square minus r square. Pi into r square minus r square. So two rings are there, that's why directly we can take as 2 into pi r square minus r square. So substitute that 2 into 22 by 7 into what is capital R, that is outer radius is 2.2 minus square, 2.2 square minus inner radius is, what is the inner radius, 2 square, that equal to 2 into 22 by 7 into 2.2, it is the form of a square minus b square. We directly we can multiply, or we can apply that a plus b into a minus b. That is 2.2 plus 2 into 2.2 minus 2. That equal to 2 into 22 by 7 into 2.2 plus 2. 4.2 into 2.2 minus 2. 0.2. Multiply. 2 into 22 by 7 into 4.2 into 0.2. How much it will be? 0.84. Now, is there any cancellation? 7 months, 0.717. And what is remaining here? 1, 4, 7, 2, 14. That is 22 into 4, 44. 44 into 0.12. Multiply that. 44 into 12. Equal to 5.28. Here before two digits there is a decimal, that's why 5.28. It is the area of ring. But actually what we have to find? Total surface area of pipe equal to outer curved surface area plus inner curved surface area plus area of the ring. So already we know that outer curved surface area, we know inner curved surface area, and just now we find that area of the ring. If we add these three, then we will get that total surface area of a pipe. Therefore, total surface area of a pipe equal to outer curved surface area. What is the outer curved surface area? Outer curved surface area is 1064.8 plus inner curved surface area, that is 968 square centimeters, and the area of ring equal to 5.28. Therefore, the total surface area of a pipe equal to, if we add, what we get? 2038.08 centimeter square. It is the total surface area of a pipe. Now come to the next problem, sixth one. A cylinder pillar has a diameter of 56 centimeters and is of 30 meters height. There are 16 pillars around the building. Find the cost of painting the curved surface area of all pillars at the rate of 5 rupees 50 paisa per meter square. So what is given there? Did you understand the problem? A building has 16 pillars are there. What they want to do? They have to paint the pillars. According to the cost is 5 rupees 50 paisa per square meter or meter square. So what is given there? The diameter of a pillar equal to problem number 6. Diameter of a pillar D equal to 56 centimeters. We require radius. Radius of a pillar R equal to 56 by 2, that equal to 28 centimeters. Height of a pillar equal to height of a pillar H equal to, how much is given? 35 meters. Height of a pillar equal to 35 meters. Total number of pillars equal to, how many pillars are there? 16. To paint that, what we should find? It is the pillar of building. Pillar of building means we should paint around us. That is nothing but what? The curved surface area of a cylinder. Pillar is in the shape of cylinder. That's why we have to find the curved surface area of a cylinder. So we have to find the curved surface area of one cylinder. Then if we multiply with 16, we will get the total curved surface area of 16 pillars. And according to the rate, we should find the total cost. And here you have to observe that the diameter is given in the centimeters, given in centimeters, and the pillar height is in meters. So we should convert that meters into centimeters or centimeters into meters. So it is 35 meters now. Change into centimeters. 1 meter equal to how much? Right, 100 centimeters. 35 meters equal to 35 into 100, that is 3500 centimeters. Now, curved surface area of a pillar, curved surface area of pillar equal to 2πRh, that is 2 into 22 by 7 into R. What is radius R equal to? 28 centimeters into H. Height is 3500 centimeters. Cancellation, the cancellation is yes, 7 months, 7 fours, 48. Now 2 into 22, 44. 44 into 35 into 4, 35 fours. 14000. Now 14,000 into 44, that is 44 into 14. How much it will be multiplied? 44 into 15, it is equal to 44 into 14, that equal to 616. that is 6,16,000. It is centimeter square. Again, if you want to find that, what is the second, the rate is given for meter square. Therefore, change it to meters. That is, if you want to change it to meters, means we should divide with the right 10,000. 616,000 by meter square. Three zeros get cancelled. Zero that equal to 61.6 meter square. So what is the cost is given here? Cost of paint per 1 meter square equal to how much it is? 5 rupees 50 paise. Total how much area is there? 61.6 meter square. Therefore, total cost of a paint equal to 61.6 into 5 rupees 50 paise. That equal to multiply 61.6 into 5 rupees 50 paise. And before that, we have to find it is the curved surface area of a one pillar. Curved surface area of one pillar. It is the cost of a one pillar it will come. So how many pillars are there like that? Right, 16 pillars are there. That is total cost of a paint equal to into 16 pillars. That is, it is equal to, because 61.6, see, understand here, curved surface area of a pillar, that is one pillar we are finding, that is a curved surface area of one pillar equal to 61.6. But actually the building have how many pillars? 16 pillars are there. That's why total curved surface area of 16 pillars equal to, we should find that 61.6 into 16. And for that, each meter square it is 5 rupees 50 paise. Therefore 61.6 into 5 rupees 50 paise into 16. Now multiply, that is 5 rupees 50 paise into 16, that is 16 paise 88. 16 into 5.5, that equal to 88. And next 61.6 into 88, that equal to 5420.8 rupees. It is the total cost to paint the 16 pillars. Therefore, total cost of 16 pillars, total cost of a paint, equal to 5420.8 rupees. It is the total cost. Now come to the problem number 7. Once read the problem 7. See what is given there. The diameter of a roller is 84 centimeters and its length is 120 centimeters. It takes 500 complete revolutions to roll once over the playground to level. Find the area of the playground in meter square. Did you understand the problem? What is given there? The diameter of a roller. Do you know the roller? Roller is in the shape of a cylinder. So roller should be like this. So if it is to level the ground, it should be rotate like this. It should be rotate like this. So if it is starting from here to rotate one round. To rotate one round means then the ground will be in the shape of rectangle. The ground will be level in the shape of rectangle. Suppose if I start from here, it is rotating like this. One round is completed. Up to here, one round is completed means the ground is in the shape of a rectangle. Like that rotates the rounds. How many rounds it will take? It takes 500 complete revolutions. So first of all, we should find the area of one round. After finding the area of one round, we can find the area of 500 rounds. That is nothing but it is equal to the area of a ground. So let us see problem number 7. The diameter of a roller is 84 centimeters. Diameter of roller is 84 centimeters. The radius of roller is 1/2 of the diameter, that is 84 by 2, that equal to 4 × 2, 42 centimeters. What it is doing? Rolling from one point to complete the one roll, it is nothing but what we are finding. It is the curved surface area of a cylinder. Already we know what is the curved surface area of the cylinder. We know the formula. Means if one round is there, means we should find the one curved surface area of the cylinder. That is, what is given there? Length, that is nothing but height of a cylinder, height of a roller, h equal to 120 centimeters. So understand, if to level the ground, it should be revolute like this. That is one revolution. Revolution is nothing but curved surface area of a cylinder. Therefore, curved surface area of a cylinder equal to curved surface area of cylinder equal to 2πRh. That is 2 × 22/7 × what is R? R equal to 42 into what is H? 120. 7 × 7, 6, 42. Now multiply 2 × 22, 44. 44 × 12, 6, 7, 20. 44 × 7, 20. Multiply. Then 3160 centimeter square. 3160 centimeter square. Find the area of playground in meter square. He is asking in meter square. So okay. So curved surface area of cylinder, that is area for one revolution equal to 3160 centimeter square. How many revolutions are there? Right, 500 revolutions. Therefore, area covered for one revolution, area covered for one revolution equal to 3160 centimeter square. How many rounds, how many revolutions are taken to level the ground? 500. So area covered for 500 revolutions equal to 500 × 3160. 500 into 3160.
How much it will be? Sorry, 44 into 720, 31,680.
It is 31,680. That is 31,680 centimeters square. So 31,680 into 500. That is equal to 1584 centimeter square. He is asking in the meter square. That's why if we want to change into the meter square, already we know it is, it should be divided by 10,000. That is equal to 30 students get cancel. 0 is 8. That is 158.4 meter square. 158.4 meter square.
Zero is there, that is zero. So four zeros will get cancelled. That is 1584 meter square.
1584 meter square. It is the area covered by the roller after completion of 500 revolutions. That is the area of a field equal to 1584 meter square. 1584 meter square. So how many 7 problems are completed, and remaining problems we will continue in the next class. Thank you.